Tubers, welcome back to Maxwell Starr's Beer Review. Tonight we're going to take a look at one of the specialties from Garrison Brewing. This is actually a summer seasonal, so we better drink it sooner than later. It is Garrison's Honey Lavender Ale. This is lavender, also known as lavandula, is a flowering plant that is part of the mint family. The leaves are long and narrow, the flowers grow in whorls, held on spikes rising above the foliage. This batch of honey lavender ale was brewed with fresh-cut lavender grown at Meander River Farm in Ashdale, Nova Scotia. The honey was produced by G.G. Smeltzer and Son at Shubenacadie. Smeltzer's honey is harvested and packaged in the Annapolis Valley. When you open this bottle, expect floral aromas, the scent of apple pie and banana. This smooth ale features flavors of honey, malt, and lavender with a hint of lemon. 6.5% ABV, and this comes in this 500 milliliter bottle. Now, one of the funny things about this is that Heistel Mighty here is actually allergic to lavender.
Well, the smell of it anyway. It stuffs up my sinuses.
Yeah, so.
So I don't know what will happen if I drink it.
Yeah.
I'm presuming, worst case scenario, it stuffs up my sinuses, fingers crossed, and doesn't stuff up my heart or something.
Yeah.
Worse than my sinuses.
And then we have to rush you to the hospital. So, but irregardless, he's a trooper.
Benadryl handy, just in case.
Irregardless, he's a trooper and a completionist. So he wants to try it anyway. So we brought back a bottle of this from Premier Wines and Spirits in Halifax, Nova Scotia. And saved it for us to try so that I can drink most of it.
Anyway, I'm tired of having this thing hang over my head like a guillotine. So it's time to get this out of the way.
Well, let's take care of it. I need some more opening skills.
Now, I've had some good luck, and I've had some bad luck with honey beer in the past. It's a real hit or miss field. But lavender, obviously, we've never tried before.
No. I mean, Picaroons came out with a special harvest ale this year called Lavenhop, which made use lavender, and I almost went to Fredericton to go get a growler load of it. But then his Benadryl thing here really convinced me otherwise. But yeah, some honey beers are really good, some honey beers aren't. So appearance-wise, it's a bit of a cloudy appearance.
It's kind of cidery.
It's almost, yeah, you're right, it is kind of cidery. Almost like it's got that slightly cinnamon apple color in there. It came up with like a half finger ahead and it's almost gone now, but it's leaving this like white, filmy appearance.
It's kind of got an oily, there's almost an oily slick that's left behind more than lacing.
Yeah.
A little weird, but okay.
Yeah. Well, on the oily side there.
I'm gonna let you smell it. Not gonna.
Yep. You can't smell the honey and the lavender. The lavender comes out. You know, you might not want to stick your nose in that, dude.
Yeah. I'm trying to get as little of this in my nasal passages as possible.
It's almost like it's got this honey apple kind of smell, but it's also got this little bit of lavender like you would expect from like a women's soaps or something. And it comes together smelling a lot like an apple cider, like a cinnamon, real cinnamony apple cider.
Well, that's interesting. Looks like cider, smells like cider.
Yeah. Wow, that's got some interesting spice. What other spices did they say that it's had?
Nothing else.
Lemon.
Nothing that they claim anyway.
There's a sweetness to it.
They might have used
three sweetness.
They might have used one of their like.
Maybe a little
they might have used one of your, like, their wit beer yeasts or something to get a little bit of spice.
Yeah, that would do it.
That would explain the banana they're claiming to have in this as well, so.
Yeah, because I didn't get a chance to try their nitwit.
The nitwit was a big banana split, like.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That sounds good. Anyway, endeavor to try more beer. Good luck, man.
See you on the other side.
Whoa.
Well, that is kind of spicy. There's definitely a spice to that. It's kind of apple pie.
It's very apple pie. Apple pie slice and spice is a little on the sour side, like a sour apple.
Yeah. It's more apple pie than some apple pies I've had, you know, if they didn't spice them right.
I mean, there's that little tinge of like soapy lavender that catches in the roof of the mouth. But for the most part, it's like this nice apple pie kind of taste. It's like, Say a pumpkin beer is to pumpkin pie, this is to apple pie. This is really nice.
It's a shame I'm scared to death of it. I would actually want to drink more of it.
How are you doing over there, sport?
Well, so far the throat has not closed off, so looking good.
It's really sour. Almost wondered if that was just because it was out of the fridge that long, or that's the way it's supposed to be.
Well,
really citrus.
I didn't put it in the fridge until today, and it hasn't been out of the fridge for more than about 5 or 10 minutes, so.
Yeah, but it might spoil in the cupboard. I mean, how old is this bottle?
It was got probably the end of August.
Oh, it's not
first of November now. And they didn't run out of their, they didn't sell out of them until mid-September. It was a late summer seasonal. Like, it didn't hit until early August, really.
Well, irregardless, it doesn't taste foul or anything. It's a nice sour apple taste, but it's, yeah, it does have that little bit of citrus, lemony citrus in the very back.
I don't know, maybe I can
soapy
handle
a lavender.
Maybe I can handle a little bit of lavender. Like, they probably didn't pour it in the same way like lavender oil perfume would be.
No, it's probably, they're pretty gentle with it at least, otherwise it might make this real foul tasting beer. Because lavender tastes somewhat soapy.
It can be pretty strong too.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we should sit down with this for a second, check my vitals, and
sure. Make sure he doesn't break out into a rash, and we'll be right back.
So far, no hives.
With Garrison Honey Lavender. So what did we think of this one? It's interesting. It tastes a lot like you would expect, like a, not a, like a cider, like a cider, alcoholic cider, but it's kind of like a, like an apple cider you would buy around Christmas time, the one that you would buy from the store and have that really like cinnamon kind of flavor, dark apple.
The one you put in the slow cooker for the afternoon kind of thing.
That kind of thing, yeah.
Yeah.
It's got that nice taste of, I mean, it's lavender, soapy lavender at the very roof, but it's very mild, so it's not off-putting. It's got this nice little sweet honey taste to the very back, but it's almost indiscernible in the sense that you can almost not tell that it's honey. And it fades into this nice herbal bitterness.
Yeah, the honey's there if you look for it, but if you weren't, if it wasn't called a honey beer, you might not notice it. But it's not absent, but it's not overpowering.
Because it says honey on the bottle, that you notice the honey there, but because, like, if it didn't say honey, you would never have known. It fades into this nice, like, herbal, earthy bitterness in the sour. It's a tiny bit sour, like citrus sour.
Yeah, it's got sour, it's got spice, tart. It's got earth, it's got some sweetness. This is really complex.
For, it's quite complex regarding what we were expecting out of this, which is...
Not much.
Yeah, supposed to be a honey lavender beer. I think honestly, you didn't really know what to expect from this because
I was really just expecting
style.
I was expecting overpowering sweet flowers, and that's not what this is at all.
No, like that lavender is just enough to be noticeable and give it a characteristic flavor, and it's other than that.
But it is
not too good.
It is in no way drinking perfume.
It's not like it's an absolutely incredible beer. Like, what would you give this out of 5?
I'm gonna say 3.25.
I was thinking 3.5, but...
I took an extra quarter point off because I'm scared it's going to kill me.
Well, there you go. All right, so I'm going to give this one a 3.5 out of 5. Iced Almighty here is going to give it a 3.25. So, thank you for watching Maxwell Starr's Beer Review of Garrison Honey Lavender, and we'll talk to you later. Cheers. You okay with Benadryl?
So far, so good.
You're okay?
I think so. Yeah. What do you mean? Wait a second.